Senator Paul, let me begin with a threshold question for you. This election was not stolen. Do you accept that fact?
Well, what I would say is that the debate over whether or not there was fraud should occur. We never had any presentation in court where we actually looked at the evidence. Most of the cases were thrown out for lack of standing, which is a procedural way of not actually hearing the question. There were several states in which the law was changed by the Secretary of State and not the state legislature. To me, those are clearly unconstitutional. And I think there's still a chance that those actually do finally work their way up to the Supreme Court.
Hey, welcome back, everybody. So before we get into breaking down this interview, let's just lay out some facts here. First of all, George Stephanopoulos is a former Clinton administration stooge. Okay, so he went from being in the Clinton administration to being in the media, and we know the media is Democrat state party media. The man is utterly untrustworthy, and we know this because of his just blatant double standards. You'll notice right at the beginning of this interview, George Stephanopoulos demands that Rand Paul say that the election wasn't stolen. He wants him to give what I think is called a belief statement. And I only say that because if you remember the video I did yesterday, I was talking about how these far-left extremist groups are trying to pressure public radio into acquiescing to their demands. And one of those demands is that they give these belief statements. Things like, there is climate change and Black Lives Matter. The goal here being to just end debate. They don't want any more talk about any of this. George Stephanopoulos wants Joe Biden's administration to be free and clear. Unlike the last election, where as soon as Trump won, they began casting doubt on the election. All right, we're going to get right back into this interview between Stephanopoulos and Rand Paul. But first, give me just 30 seconds for this message from this episode's sponsor, Noble Gold. You know, it's a new year. Time for new things. With a new administration in Washington, our friends at Noble Gold have all the protection you need. How? By using gold and silver in your own IRA. You insulate it from the markets. If anything bad happens, you're safe and dry. Protect with a gold IRA this month, and Noble Gold will gift you this stunning solid silver Apollo 11 commemorative coin from the U.S. Mint. So it's worth jumping on the phone and calling 877-646-5347 now. That's 877-646-5347.
We should get to the bottom of it. I'll give you an example. In my state, when we had a Democrat Secretary of State, she refused, even under federal order, to purge the rolls of illegal voters. We got a Republican Secretary of State, and he purged the rolls.
Senator Paul,
it does make a difference, and those things do have to stop
you there. No election is perfect, but there were 86 challenges filed by President Trump and his allies in court. All were dismissed. Every state certified the results after investigations, counts, and recounts. The Department of Justice, led by William Barr, said there's no widespread evidence of fraud. Can't you just say the words, election was not stolen?
Basically, it's just like I always say. The media and the Democrats want everybody to think that the only legitimate election is one that Democrats win. They have planted into people's heads that anytime Democrats lose an election, the country is in flux and democracy is threatened. You see, he just wants him to say the words. Just say the words so that we can carry on like the Biden administration is legitimate, unlike we do for every single Republican administration. Like I said before, it's just the opposite. George Stephanopoulos took exactly the opposite position when Trump won. Instead of demanding that Democrats accept election results, he berated Republicans to admit that the election was stolen by Russia.
Does President Trump accept the conclusion that Russia was behind this?
This is fake news. I think it's just fake. I would take the news word right out of it.
So you say it's fake. Is this a categorical denial of everything in the dossier? And it's a consensus conclusion
that people are hacking all the time.
But that Russia was behind it. Russian hacking the election.
Russia hacked the American election.
Russia hacked and interfered with the U.S. election.
That election hacking.
President-elect Trump saying he knows things we don't about election-related hacking.
Trump team still sending out mixed signals about whether they believe Russia was behind the hacking of the election.
He might start to move towards accepting these conclusions of the intelligence community that Russia was indeed involved in this election. Well, 75% of Republicans agree with you because they were fed a big lie by President Trump and his supporters who say the election was stolen. Why can't you say
Hey, George.
Okay, I know you all want to just watch this interview, but I got to interject here again. It's just amazing to me that he can't see how completely hypocritical he's being here. Why can't you just accept that this election wasn't stolen? Why couldn't they accept that the election wasn't stolen? It's astounding that they can't even think for a second that the other side could be trying to hold them to their own standards. It seems to Democrats and left-wingers, the idea of holding themselves to their own standards is as baffling as the vastness of the universe.
The mistake is that people coming from the liberal side like you, you immediately say everything's a lie instead of saying there are two sides to everything. Historically, what would happen is if I said that I thought there was fraud, you would interview someone else who said there wasn't. But now you insert yourself in the middle and say the absolute fact is that everything I'm saying is a lie.
Well, because, Senator, I said what the president said was a lie because he said, hold on a second. He said the election was stolen. This election was not stolen. The results were certified in every single state after counts and recounts.
You're saying that absolutely it was, you're saying there was no fraud and it's all been investigated. That's just not true.
I said something that was not true.
You say we're all liars. You're just simply saying we're all liars. And
I said it was a lie that the election was stolen.
Premise that you're right and we're wrong. Well, let's talk about the specifics of it. In Wisconsin, tens of thousands of absentee votes had only the name on them and no address. Historically, those were thrown out. This time, they weren't. They made special accommodations because they said, oh, it's a pandemic and people forgot what their address was. So they changed the law after the fact. That is wrong. That's unconstitutional. And I plan on spending the next 2 years going around state to state and fixing these problems. And I won't be cowed by liberals in the media who say, there's no evidence here and you're a liar if you talk about election fraud. No, let's have an open debate. It's a free country.
Look, the fact is, I'm no lawyer. I really have no idea what kind of credibility all of these claims have. When Rand Paul talks about that, that sounds pretty serious, and I hope he gets to the bottom of it. But the fact of the matter is, and he rightly points out, that George Stephanopoulos has already made a decision. He's acting more like an activist or a propagandist and much less like a journalist. A journalist would really want to stick their teeth into this story. They'd want to dig and investigate. But these people don't want to do that. Oh, wait, they did want to do that when Trump won. When Trump won, suddenly they became these democracy-defending, hard-hitting, just-the-facts journalists, right? But when a Democrat wins, suddenly it's like overnight it all changes, and they immediately circle the wagons, and they want to push a narrative that advances the Democrat Party agenda. And again, the only criticism or scrutiny you're going to see for the next 4 years will be of people like Rand Paul. It'll be of critics and of the Democrat Party opposition.
There's no widespread evidence of election fraud that overturned the results.
Again, that very well may be true. But that doesn't mean you just don't investigate it and you just sort of cover it up and never speak of it again. And instead of investigating it, you go out and you try to get these belief statements from people to basically just absolve you, George Stephanopoulos, of having to do your job as a journalist. That's all you're looking for, is to be absolved of your duty to hold Democrats and Democrat president to account, because that's not your job. Your job is the exact same thing it was when you were in the Clinton administration. You're a spin doctor. You're a propagandist. And this is exactly why trust in the media has plummeted to all new lows.
In Wisconsin, there were counts and recounts.
Actually, it was
the
never studied. Even that's not true.
William Barr said that directly.
But there was, yes, he said that. Yes, that was a pronouncement. There has been no examination, thorough examination of all the states to see what problems we had and see if they could fix them. Now, let me say, to be clear, I voted to certify the state electors because I think it would be wrong for Congress to overturn that. But at the same time, I'm not willing just to sit here and say, oh, everybody on the Republican side is a liar and there is no fraud. No, there were lots of problems and there were secretaries of state who illegally changed the law, and that needs to be fixed. And I'm going to work hard to fix it. And I won't be cowed by people saying, oh, you're a liar. That's the problem with the media today, is they say all Republicans are liars and everything we say is a lie. There are two sides to every story. Interview somebody on the other side, but don't insert yourself into the story to say we're all liars because we think there's some fraud in the election.
There are not two sides to the story. This has been looked at in every single state. The election
There are two sides to every story. George, you're forgetting who you are. You're forgetting who you are as a journalist. If you think there's only one side, you're inserting yourself into the story to say, I'm a liar because I want to look at election fraud and I want to look at secretaries of state who illegally changed the voter laws without the permission of their state legislatures. That is incontrovertible. It happened. And you can't just sweep that under the rug and say, oh, nothing to see here. And everybody's a liar and you're a fool if you bring this up. You're inserting yourself into the story. A journalist would hear both sides, and there are two sides of this story.
Come on now, Stephanopoulos. There wasn't really enough time to look into any of these things. And like Rand Paul mentioned earlier, these judges aren't just going to inject themselves and change, overturn election results based on the investigations that have been done so far. It's kind of strange that people in the media that should be wanting to investigate this don't seem interested in that at all. And in fact, what they are interested in is discrediting anybody who may ask questions. I just want to point out again that during the last election, when Trump won and Democrats were coming out and saying that Russia hacked the election and stole it, instead of the media going out and demanding that these Democrats declare that the election was legitimate and Trump was legitimate, that never happened. Instead of that, they went out and bolstered the conspiracy theories and for 4 years did everything they could to undo a Democratic election. So whether there's any truth to any of these claims about the election or not, the media has sown the seeds for this, and it's really no coincidence that every time a Republican wins, then conspiracy theories about stolen elections are mainstream and widespread.
Not say that this was a perfect election. I said it was. The results were certified. I said it was not stolen. It is
You're
a lie to
people
say
people are
it
liars.
Not
You're
stolen.
Saying people are liars if they want to investigate what happened in the election. Should
That's
we
not
investigate
what I said.
The fact that tens of thousands of absentee ballots did not have addresses on them and normally were disqualified, but this time they were counted? Should we examine that? I don't know whether it affected the election or not, but I have an open mind.
There can be more investigations. The investigations that have taken place have shown there is not enough fraud to change the results of this election. That has been certified by every state. It was stated by the Justice Department and the Attorney General.
And I accepted the state certifications, but doesn't mean that I think that there wasn't fraud and that there weren't problems that have to be investigated, and it doesn't mean that the law wasn't broken. I believe in Pennsylvania they broke the law, and I believe if that ever would get a real hearing in the Supreme Court, it was denied for standing. It wasn't actually taken up. If it were taken up, I do believe that the Supreme Court would overrule and say that they did break the law illegally.
I asked you a very simple question. Was the election stolen or not?
I think there was a great deal of evidence of fraud and changing of the election laws illegally, and I think a thorough investigation is warranted.
Senator Paul, thanks for your time this morning.
Folks, Trump's election was certified in every state. And don't forget that the Democrats did everything they could to try and influence electors to not vote for Trump when it came time. And despite all the evidence that the Steele dossier, for example, was actually Russian disinformation, the media didn't care. They went ahead and spread it anyway. And for 4 years, they claimed that the president was a Russian agent and that his supporters an existential threat. And now, but now, they want us all to fall in line, bend our knees, and kiss the ring. That's all for this one. Please hit that like button, share, and subscribe. If you want to support this channel or follow me on any of the alternate platforms, you can find all those links in the description or pinned comment. Thanks for watching. Keep coming back.